All right, so first thing, this is just going to be finishing the offseason and doing preseason. So if you are just looking to watch gameplay, go ahead and click on the next video. You'll find the next video there. Otherwise, if you want to see how it all goes down, this is the stream for you. I do have a funny story about why I'm starting this stream so late, but I'm going to save that for a little bit later. I'm going to get things going up here. So the thing is, last stream, you will notice, we won the national championship. F yeah. Go back and watch the old videos. It was a hell of a lot of fun. One and done at Alabama. So we did pick our new school. We did the coaching carousel right away. Debated for a little bit, but got our new school. And I did most of the offseason. We just have conference realignment left. And then I think offseason is done. And then we're going to do our preseason stuff. So we have a lot of like transfer portal. A couple people have coaches because they subscribed on Twitch. So we have a couple things to wrap up here. So Alabama, you're going to be the first one to decide, and this can all be on screen. So number one would be West, number two would be East. And again, like, I used to put a lot of thought, my previous dynasty, I put a lot of thought into division names. I started to think that people don't really care about division names that much, so stop wasting my time thinking about it. Okay, so Alabama, one is West, two is East. Generate, there are two. So they're over there. Let's go ahead and not screw up our very first one. Okay, whatever, it's red, I don't care. Next one, two. Alabama and Auburn, still in the same division. Okay, next one. Two. Is it actually clicking here? I know I missed that one. There's freaking no way. Okay, this one's for real now. Boom. One. And no, I did not purposely move Georgia to the other side. I just really was starting to really guess whether I was clicking it or not. And that's why the other way I was going to do this, it was to like type out all the teams and have like a random generator split them into two groups. That I thought this would be more exciting to do it one at a time. They were like, all right, where's UAB going to be? Where's Georgia Southern going to be? I just forgot that it might be a little bit like, wait, did I misclick? Is it still the same number because I misclicked or what? Well, there we go. We pretty much got all the Georgias on one side. We'll see. Let's do South Alabama first. Two. And we... okay. Well, at least we split up the Georgias and the Bamas. And we know the Floridas are going to split up because there's two and four. So let's start from the top. Two. And if Florida goes over there, it's going to be loaded. Nope, Florida did not go over there. Two. There it is. So that is full. There we can just put the rest over here. So it's still pretty well split up. If we're thinking that there's some big dogs, Georgia is a big dog, Florida, Miami. So that's three big dogs. Alabama, Auburn, Florida State, three big dogs. UCF actually had a pretty decent record last year. And Georgia Tech should be a big-ish dog. But yeah, that looks pretty balanced. Okay, let's do the same thing with the CX, starting with Texas A&M. One and one again. I did click it right. I really could do this faster by like doing one, okay, two and one, two and one, one and two, one and two. Let's see if Mississippi State can stay on the same side as Ole Miss. Two. They are not. Wow. And also, I thought this would be cool too, because like we split up all the Florida schools, but we also have the chance to split up these ACC schools. Where are they at? Wake Forest, North Carolina, Clemson, NC State, Duke. One, two. So that's five ACC schools make up this conference. And I was like, you know what? If they're going to be in a conference with all these former SEC schools, let's at least like mix it up a little bit. Let's not force them to be all in the same division and have like guarantee you have to play an SEC, former SEC school in the championship game. All right, so let's do two schools here, two and one. And I'm pretty sure we're still going to get a guaranteed South Carolina Clemson rivalry game anyway. That's 1-1. And that division's full. So there we go. Clemson and South Carolina, same division again. See? There you go. So that is officially the end of the off season. So since we are moving to a new school, anyone who redeemed players, you got a player either by subscribing or by using channel points. If your player still had eligibility left, you're not just going to lose it because we happen to win the national championship in chain schools. So there are, okay, and that's why I was going to pull up that other list. So we're going to do transfer portal first. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 guys still had eligibility left. So we have 6 seniors, and then actually Nathan Cardinals, he redeemed his quarterback Paxton Lynch originally for Texas, transferred with us over to Alabama, and now he's transferring with us again. So I'm at work. You guys know I work the night shift, but second shift. So right now I've been starting at 1 o'clock. You know, working your 8 hours, if you have to work late, 9-10 hours. So it's like when I get home, when I'm normally getting home from work, it'll be like 10 p.m., 11 p.m., midnight. So if you drive all the way home from work and then check your jacket pocket and your apartment keys are not there, you check your little, not a glove box, your little like compartment next to the driver's seat, like in between the driver's seat and the passenger seat, where you sometimes put your apartment keys and they're not there. And you're like, where the F are my apartment keys? Because normally I drive to work. And when I get to work, take my apartment keys, put them in there, get my ID badge out. So it's like an even swap. So I always do that when I get to work, because you need your ID badge to get in billing. Sometimes I'm in a rush and I don't take my apartment keys out and put them. I just like grab my ID badge and like go in, try to get inside and clock in. So it's like, I'm not as late. So my apartment keys are always in my jacket pocket or in the little compartment next to the driver's seat in my car. I drive all the way home. They're nowhere to be found. I'm like, oh my God. So, you know, get out your flashlight. Look. Make sure you're looking through, like, I got some random spare batteries in there for some reason. I should probably take those out, like it's old receipts and stuff. It's like, okay, it's definitely not in here. Did it fall between, I check in between the seats, I check under the seats. I'm like, it's not freaking here. I'm going to have to drive back to work. Now, fortunately, at that time of the night, it's not the, like, 30-minute drive that it is on the way there. But, you know, in Madison, all over Wisconsin, but where I live in Madison, we have had two different snowfalls, blizzards really, but one of them was like multiple days. So it's like 3 full days last week of snow, wind, snow, wind. And now the past few days this week, it's been below zero temperatures. With wind adding it to it, so like your real feel, wind chill, all that, like well below zero. So if you are from northern parts of the country, you know this. If it snows, and then it's freezing, freaking cold, yes, the roads like get plowed and they're drivable, but they're not like 100% clear. Like, yeah, you can lay down salt, you can lay down sand, but if it's been snowing, and cars have been driving across it, packing it down, it's just, you're not gonna be able to clear all the way down to the pavement with snow plows. Like, you're gonna get all the loose stuff, but it's just gonna be like a layer of hard packed snow. And then like, if it got hit with a little sun, you know, whatever, it melts a little bit, get to the middle of the day, maybe it gets enough sun, it melts. Boom, overnight turns to ice. Or if it gets to below zero temperatures like it's been, it's freezing cold. Anyway, that's a long way of saying the roads are absolute garbage. So if my drive to work would normally be between, like, let's say, like, between 22 and 32 minutes to get to work, or, and then to get back, there's a lot less traffic, so probably like 20 to 25 minutes to get back. Well, not if the roads as shitty as they are, so it's like at least half an hour, probably more than that each way. So I had driven home. Like, I don't have my keys anywhere. I must have left them at work somewhere. So I drive all the way back to work. And I get there, and there's like a couple of coworkers are still there. Like, what are you doing here? Like, I thought you went home, et cetera, et cetera. I'm like, I don't know where my apartment keys are. So anyway, we're talking. I'm looking everywhere. I go check, like, we each have like lockers. Go check my locker. It's not anywhere in there. I rode in a semi truck with one of the other drivers for his route today. So like, went and got the keys for that truck, went out there, looked out, got my flashlight, looking all over. I'm like, okay, the keys didn't fall out of my jacket in there. Come back, and I'm like talking to the guys again. I'm like, what am I gonna do? Like, obviously, you can see now, I'm in my apartment, so how did I figure it out? What solved it? Well, I'm like, okay, I have the landlord's phone number, which is like an office phone number. No one's in the office at midnight. So the other one is like emergency lockout or whatever, the like resident manager. It's like, okay, I don't have their phone number saved in my phone. I'm a freaking idiot. Why would I, you know, the emergency phone number, you should have it in your phone for emergencies. Didn't have it. But it's like, okay, well, I know where the resident manager lives, and you could go knock. Because it's, you can get, I don't want to give too much information away, but yeah, so I could go like knock loudly and try to wake them up and be like, hey, can you let me in my apartment? One, you'd get charged a fee for that. Two, if I still can't find my keys anyway, I'd get charged for like having to I don't know if they probably wouldn't rekey the whole building, but they'd rekey my apartment. I'd get charged for that. It's like multiple charges. Plus it's like a huge hassle and blah, blah, blah. It's like, okay. I have to figure out where my freaking keys are. So I did not do that. I did eventually find my keys. So talking some more of one of my coworkers, be like, okay, what was your whole work day like? Yes. Okay. So when you came in, where did you go? What did you do when you got back from the route? And I was like, you know, it's like, okay, I was working over here, but like, I wouldn't have been wearing my jacket then. No, so I took my jacket off. Where did I put my jacket? And like somewhere along in that conversation, it hit me. I was like, you know what? Let me go check my locker again and see how many jackets are in there. Go and check my locker. There's no jackets in there. I'm like, okay, there's supposed to be a jacket in there. That means at some point, the jacket that was in there, I took out. That's most likely the jacket I was currently wearing. Which means the jacket that I like brought from home that has my apartment keys in it is somewhere else. And it's like, okay. So instead of taking the jacket that I brought from home and putting it back on and going home and having my apartment keys, I had forgotten, left that jacket somewhere and went and grabbed a different jacket and went home. So it's like, okay, boom, problem solved. I just have to find that jacket. Well, I like go in the break room and there's a jacket in there. And I'm like, hey, you know, coworker, is that your jacket or is that? He's like, no, yeah, that's my jacket. I'm like, okay, my jacket's not here. Like, check this room. So like, finally, like, go back out on the warehouse. I'm like, oh, like I found where I'd set it, like off to the side. And I'm like, I 100% do not remember putting my jacket there. Like, what the heck was going on? I literally do not remember my jacket there. But yeah. Find my jacket, reach in, there's my freaking apartment keys. Story's not done though. There's another wrinkle coming up. So yeah, blah, blah, blah. Tell my coworker, found my jacket. Yeah, but thanks for like helping me walk back all my steps through the thought process, helping me like not panic. And well, one of them definitely offered me to go sleep on his couch if I needed to. And the other one like would have offered me, but I think he was kind of like glad the other guy was like officially offering and I didn't have to go to his place. But anyway, yeah, thankful to my coworkers for not only one helping me figure out where my keys might have been, but also like offering me a place to stay if I like didn't want to like bang on my resident manager's door and get charged all kind of fees just because I needed somewhere to sleep the night and not have to sleep in my car. Anyway, problem solved. We chit chat for a while, and then a whole bunch of people like, around midnight are leaving. So like, okay, I'll leave too. I'll head home. It's like it's already like I'm not gonna be able to like do a 2-3 hour stream, so I might as well just like hang out and talk to these guys. Thank for okay, but whatever. Boom, drive home. I'm like, man, that was crazy. I'm like, that was an unusual night. I can't believe I did that. Like, I've gotten really good about not losing stuff. I used to be really bad about like losing my wallet or losing my phone or losing my keys. I've gotten really good. I don't do that anymore. I was like, oh my God, I can't believe I like misplaced my keys and just could not figure where they were. So I'm like 3 minutes from my house. Like I said, after probably what was like a 23 minute drive. So I'm 3 minutes from my house. I'm like, okay, let me just check like that I have my keys this time. Wouldn't it be like so stupid if I like forgot my jacket or left my keys or lost my keys again and have to like go back and go through the whole process? And I think like all my coworkers had left by then. Nobody would be there. I'd be like, oh my God. Check my pants pocket. Not there. I'm like, wait a minute. I thought I put them in my pants. My jacket pocket? No, not in my jacket pocket. Okay, why would I have put them in my center console in my car if I was like, I had no reason to take them out of my jacket if I knew I was gonna. So I'm like, okay, they're not in the center console. I'm at a stoplight, like 3 minutes from my house. Not here, not here, not here. Then I'm starting to panic again. I'm like, what? I just went through this. How am I losing my keys? Like after immediately after going through this whole process of finding them. So stoplight turns green. I pull off on a side, like pull over, do the whole thing again. Flashlight on my phone, look in. I'm like, oh my God, am I having to get out? Like, I'm going to have to freaking drive back to work. Like, I think I put them in my other jacket and just absentmindedly must have put that jacket down on the counter or something, or put it back in my, I must have just put the keys in that jacket and then left that jacket at work again, like a freaking idiot. So I turn around and I'm driving back to work again. I'm like, I cannot believe this. I drove all the way home and all the way back to work, found the keys, drove 95% of the way home, and now I'm gonna have to drive back to work and drive all the way back home again. I was like, I am the dumbest MFer in the world. I'm like, what's wrong with me? Did I have like lack of sleep? Like my coworkers are gonna think I'm on drugs or something. That I keep losing my keys. So I turn around and go like 3 minutes down the road, and I'm like, because I'm thinking like, how did I do this again? Where did I put it? Did I leave it? I'm like, what did I do with these keys that I just like celebrated? I was like doing stupid little jumps in there and like making my coworkers laugh. It's like, ah. You're really happy you found me? I'm like, yeah, hell yeah, I'm really happy you found my keys. I was like, I was just doing that, and how did, this is so embarrassing, I just lost them again. Where could I have put them? And that's when it hit me. I'd been talking about my coworkers, like, where I keep my keys or whatever, and, like, one of my coworkers showed me his that has, like, his car keys, his apartment keys, these keys. He's got, like, so many freaking keys on one big keychain. And I'm like, yeah, I don't do that because blah, blah, blah. I'm like, you know what? I should. I'm just going to start doing that. Put the car keys and my apartment keys on the same chain. I'm like, I put my apartment keys on with my car keys, which I'm currently driving my car. I reach up. Yep, they're dangling. I'm like, I thought I lost my keys a second time after driving all the way home a second time, and I was ready to drive back to work again. And it's like, no, they're on the same keychain as your car keys, which you are currently driving. So they're in the ignition. I was like, oh my God. Maybe still I am the dumbest person in the world, but I really thought for a second there that I was the dumbest person in the world who like lost their keys again. Like, immediately after finding your lost keys. I thought, it was like, oh my God, I cannot believe this is happening to me. So that is why like technically I'm streaming this, but I'm betting most of you are just watching this on video. So yeah, that is why I was not able to stream tonight, and I'm only able to do just the preseason, like finishing the offseason preseason stuff. I don't have time to play any games. So the next video or the way our game is going to start, because I am a moron and cannot keep track of my keys. That is that story. So I hope you don't think less of me, and thank you for listening to my story about thinking I was gonna have to like sleep in my car in below zero temperatures. Oh my god. Honestly, I probably wouldn't have slept in my car. If like none of my coworkers had offered or something, I don't know. Maybe I would have gotten a hotel, but you know, I'm pretty cheap. I probably would have just found some cushy blankets or something at work and like slept at work. I wouldn't even care. I'd be like, you know what? Like slept at work, and then when like normal business hours, getting my resident manager to let me in my apartment at no charge, because I think you only get charged if it's like after hours. So it's like I would have just slept at work. So yeah, I was this close to sleeping at work tonight. Anyway, thank you for listening to my random story. Let's get back on the main thing here. So our last guy, last transfer portal guy, is from Quantum. It is Peen Slappy, entering his senior year, the shutdown corner. And he was number 69. I remember he was the first guy to get number 69 there. So we have our senior right there. If you subscribe to me on Kick, I will gift you 3 months on Twitch. So if you subscribe on Kick, you're going to get 3 players, 3 coaches, 2-1, 1-2, all for the price of whatever it is in your country. In the United States, it's just $5 United States. But I know, at least on Twitch anyway, I don't know if it's true on Kick, but yeah, different prices. No, I'm going to have to find number 69. But yeah, for $5. Support the stream. Maybe buy me a... Oh, what's the... Laminar? No, not that one. Anyway, buy me a large keychain. Keep track of my keys. So who the heck is number 69? I think I'm going to just go to the all positions. All right, so our suggestions were Wisconsin at Lambeau Field and Central Michigan, because they were in the playoffs last year, and or Old Dominion, because they were also a pretty good small school. So the guy who was offering that one was like, yeah, no, let's play these other smaller schools that, like, they're good, but they're still small. So it's like it's appropriate matchup for you, like a good challenge. Minnesota's ranked? Oh, yeah, they've been better lately. Central Michigan's also available. Okay, I think I might go ahead and take one of those. Wisconsin? See, that's what I'm saying. They're number 7, bro. We might have to wait a year before we want to play against them. I don't really like any of the options there. I think we're gonna make that an open game. Let's go ahead and just pick a random team here so I can lock this in as open. And yes, you guys, if you didn't know, I'm a little bit OCD on the stuff like that. You're like, man, how long does it take to pick a schedule? It's like, well, it's going to affect, like, my next 2-3 weeks of gaming. I want it to be good. And plus, I'm, like, recording everything for posterity. It's like, oh, why did you pick this schedule? It's like, well, I want to be able to defend my argument. Be like, okay, here's why I did this and this and this. Central Michigan sounds good. I want to make it at home. I want to find out what my home stadium looks like. I could keep Colorado. That means I probably want a ranked team. Would I make it Wisconsin? You know, I think just to reward the people who spent time in my chat while we were doing the last stream. Reward the people who are active in chats. I think I am going to go and do Wisconsin against my better judgment. And I'm going to make it the third game, the third non-conference game, so that way I've got a little bit of practice with my team. Did I want to do it on a neutral? It's realistically Central Michigan could come here. I don't think it's realistic to have Colorado come to San Jose. I could make it a neutral site. Let's just make them both neutral site. So Wisconsin, how do you set that? Select location. It's almost like I've never done this before. Lambeau Field. Okay, and then I will play Colorado. Can we do it at Empower Field at Mile High? Oh, wait, that's not much of a neutral field. Where does UNLV plays at Allegiant? Let's go there. Unless that's going to be all decked out in UNLV colors. So I'm looking for Allegiant Stadium. Nope, it's not on the list, I guess. We'll just take the chance it's all decked out in UNLV colors. So there we go. We got neutral with Coach Prime. Neutral with my boys in red, the Badgers, at Lambeau Field, home of the Packers. And then we've got a regular game against the MAC champions, who got a 12-team playoff invite. Surprised they're not ranked. They should be ranked. I wonder if the rankings are based on, like, overall, like, talent. All right, so there. Now I can say I put definite thought into my schedule. It is thorough. So now next is redshirting players. Redshirting players and coming up with a recruiting plan. God, I cannot believe I'm already this far. It is time to redshirt your players, come up with a recruiting plan, and literally, I was so scared thinking about how I'm going to recruit this first season. Like, what level of player I should target, how high up I should target. And now, the moment is freaking here. I'm serious, I'm not even kidding right now. Like, I'm really nervous for this rebuild. Oh my god. I hope you guys are going to enjoy watching this. I hope you guys can hear this song, Inside Out by Eve Six. One of the businesses I went to on that guy's route, the music playing inside the building was literally this song. And like both of us knew a lot of the words. We were like singing along with it. But we didn't know the title. So then I Googled the lyrics and it's like, oh, that's Eve Six. Inside Out by Eve Six came out in 1998. And literally Spotify. Oh, Spotify, you've been listening to me on my phone, haven't you? Redshirt players. SJSU. All right, we are redshirting players, and we're going to make our recruiting plan at the same time. That's how I like to do it. Like, if I know I need to redshirt somebody, or figuring out, it's because it has the same... Okay, we are redshirting players, and I like to come up with a recruiting plan at the same time because it's the same ideas come into it. So, like, junior, not great sophomore or freshman, they're all been redshirts. So it's like there's no redshirt options there, but we also do have like a lot of youth. So it's like we don't need players immediately. We just need good players. So would I say I need one quarterback or would I need two quarterbacks? I probably wouldn't say I need two quarterbacks, but say I get two quarterbacks, they're likely to be better than these guys. So I'm going to say 1-2. And I normally don't write notes like this, but maybe for the rebuild I will say 1-2 if they're good. But one for sure. Running back, we have a junior, 75. This sophomore, he's not been redshirted yet. Away, Okay, so he'd be in the same class as him if them if I redshirt. I think I should redshirt, because then he would be a senior, and then these three would all be sophomore redshirt, so they'd be 2 years apart. So then when the senior leaves, this guy would be like the next best one, and he'd still have 2 years of him. And honestly, like, do you need him as a backup this year? No, not really. Are you going to be able to recruit above him? Maybe, probably not. Probably not, honestly. So I'm going to redshirt him, counting on him maybe to be our eventual starter unless we hit a home run in recruiting. So what do we need to recruit then? Again, kind of like with quarterbacks, like we've got our potential starter. We just need better. We just need better players above them. We don't necessarily need two though. So I'm gonna say again. I'm just gonna say one, and hopefully I'm gonna know what I'm talking about when I say if good. Fullbacks, we don't need one. Fullback zero. Wide receiver. That's right. We had a ton of receivers, but three of them are seniors. Gosh, these guys are not great. But again, so normally what I would do is like, okay, if they're so bad that I want to cut them, I wouldn't even bother redshirting them, because like most of their use is going to come from like just being on the roster right now and being like, if there's a rash of injuries at the position, that they'll be able to fill in. And then like in the next year, I'd have somebody better and I'd cut them. But I don't necessarily think. I don't think that's going to be the case, because we have three seniors leaving. So if we don't recruit super well, we're going to actually need them to stick around. So four wide receivers right now. Do I really need the fifth available? Or would I rather have an extra year out of them? I'd rather have an extra year. Would I redshirt all of these? So I think the story I said before with the 63, I'm just going to leave the 63 alone, but we're going to redshirt these other ones. And we're going to definitely need some fill-ins. These guys are all leaving. And these guys are all really, really shitty. Can I recruit three wide receivers? Seniors are leaving, senior and junior. Wow, that is some not great. There's a lot of old people there, so he will not be redshirted, but maybe this junior should be? I mean, I'm not going to need him this year. You might need him next year, so that's fine. I'm going to say one to two tight ends. God, this list is going to be huge. I think I'm going to need so many. Okay, 79. Senior, sophomore. I'm just going to assume that he's going to get redshirted. Sophomore. Junior, we're not going to redshirt him. 71, 66, 76. Really hope I can recruit over a lot of these guys. Gosh, you're not going to get redshirted. You're just going to play. Probably not play, but be available to play. I can always redshirt that guy next year. Let's redshirt him now. So is that all the offensive linemen? Good there. Good there. Good there. Good there. Good there. So how many do I need to recruit? The senior's leaving, and that guy is going to be a junior. Senior's leaving, that guy's going to be a junior. Still got a little time with this center. Plus, you potentially have this guy, which would be 1 year behind him then. This guy's going to be a senior. This guy wouldn't be wonderful. Yeah, I think it's just going to be my usual 3 to 4. Excuse me. ID line sophomore, he's pretty young. Wow, this might be like our best player on the roster. These guys are old. 77. Okay, so that's not as bad as I thought it would be. Every time I write down the recruiting plan, I always debate whether I should separate D end from D tackle. Man, these guys suck. So he'll be good. He'll be good. So D tackle's not okay. So this is actually my best looking position here. I'm still gonna want some. D line, one. Oh, redshirting. So can't redshirt any of them. Can't redshirt any of them. These guys probably are not worth redshirting. I'll just do one. Linebackers, you're a senior, you're a junior. Sophomore 80, you're gonna start, so I probably can redshirt both of you. Because I've got the junior to play backup. Senior, junior, jeez, 66. So maybe I'll keep you available. And I'll keep you available. Okay, so these freshmen are not good. Hopefully I should be able to recruit over them. The sophomore is going to be a junior next year, and then that's going to be gone. And that's going to be gone. So we didn't need a lot of linebackers, but we didn't need a lot of linemen. D-linemen, but linebackers we definitely need. I'm going to say, like, we want three, one for each position. Even though a lot of times I'll play two middle linebackers, you might want more than that, but... three is pretty high number from what I usually write down. Okay, so we got three seniors. So that means we need some corners. So we've got a couple freshmen already. So we hopefully should be able to recruit better than that. So what would be a high number? Two, like three corners in one class is pretty large. Yeah. I'm going to say 2 to 3, and we're going to lean towards 2. So I circled 2 because that's what I do with the quarterback, 1 to 2, but I lean towards 1. All right, safety. Senior, senior, senior. Wow. Okay, freshman redshirt might be able to be my starter for a while. Senior, junior, senior, freshman, gonna redshirt. So again, safety, we're not looking too terrible. Oh, you know, I remember when we looked at position changes, I tried moving a lot of these safeties and corners around. And there wasn't a lot of movement to be had. And I wonder if I could just redshirt this dude. He's the fourth corner on the depth chart. Because I think this might be a safety that I moved over. So he probably not played that much. You know what? He wouldn't play that much. And if I needed like a fourth defensive back or a fourth corner on the field for dime or quarter packages... we've got plenty of safeties to do it. So then this way, when the two seniors are gone next year, he can still be around. He can be a starter next year with Bowie. So we're going to do the unusual circumstance of redshirting a senior. Dude's 4 years into his college career and coach is like, you know what? You're not going to play this year. It's like, bro, I've been waiting. I went 3 years without playing. Can I tell me I'm not going to play again? Yes, sir. Safeties. Well, I mean, obviously you're going to need some safeties, but maybe it would just be depth. Because really, I've run into this problem before where it's like, oh, 71. I need somebody better than 71. Then if you recruit like a 74, then this guy is going to be better than 74 next year. So it's like, oh, wait, he's by the time his career is over, he's only been a starter for 1 year because the guy ahead of him was always like, okay, comparing how good they are as juniors, the second guy is better, but they're never both juniors. It's like one's a senior and one's a junior. So the guy who's a senior is better than the junior. If you get what I mean, like he's always a class ahead. So his ranking is always ahead or his overall is always ahead. So let's not do that to ourselves this time. Let's just assume Michael Hill will be the starter next year. And then this guy would be the starter next year. And then this guy, again, the same thing. He would be a redshirt freshman. So yeah, we're not dying for safeties. I could maybe get one. But honestly, if we're prioritizing where our scouting points are going to be and where our recruiting points are going to go, 3 wide receivers, 1 to 2 quarterbacks, 1 running back, 1 to 2 tight ends, 3 to 4 O-linemen, 3 linebackers, 2 to 3 corners. Yeah, I don't think we're going to prioritize safety at all. Kicker, he's a junior. We don't need to do it. Punter, he's a freshman. Oh my god, he's terrible. Oh, I've literally never done this before, but I'm about to do it. Punter, 0 to 1. Like, we don't need one. But if we can get somebody who's better than that, which should not be that hard to get somebody better than that. Oh my god, so that is our recruiting plan. Al Smith's actually not that bad. But we have a named player, so we're going to go with the named player. Yes, you get special treatment. Julio Jones Jr. Punt returns. Probably really do need agility. We're not going to go with Julio Jones on punt returns. Kind of needs breaking tackles, though. Would we go with Hunter? Parrying is really good. Again, the only return number I didn't want was Emright. Okay. So let's go ahead and do Hunter. Right after we find out who our offensive coordinator and defensive coordinators are. Let me guess. Oh, that's right. I remember we hired them and they were both brand new people. Oh my god. Can I interest the two people who are due coaches, can I interest you guys in being my offensive and defensive coordinators? That would be fun. If we had success and you guys, like, eventually, if I left or you guys got hired away, that would be cool. They're also, like, these brand new people who, like, these names are just made up anyway. Okay, D coordinator. Oh my god, I'm just kind of panicking how rough this is going to be. Like, your offense plays so much better with all these skills leveled up. Good thing I have my game management tree almost 100% full. Alright, D coordinator. We need our power and our finesse moves. Offensive coordinator. Oh my god, that's all we get. Carrying. Okay. Just keep in mind, I do not have my recruiting tree leveled up, so I cannot put 700 points per player. So I'm going to fall behind. Like, I can't go for the 5 stars. I'm definitely not going for 5 stars. Probably not even 4 stars, because I would not be able to keep up with the Texases, the Alabamas, the Georgias, the Ohio States. And let's take a look at pipeline states. Ah, just California. I figured it was going to be just California. So no deal breakers, any level of interest, obviously not committed. So let's start with our pipeline state. I almost said states. State singular. Oh my god. So tempted to go after that guy. Let's take a look. Conference prestige, not bad. Proximity to home, very important. Would it really hurt to scout him? How bad would it be to spend a few points scouting him? Ooh, can't, no athletes allowed. No athletes allowed, and we need to increase our sliders because we won the national championship last year. That was one thing I had to remember to do when we flipped over to the new season. How do you make the game more difficult? It would be a shame if I couldn't remember how to do it and I didn't have to make my players worse. And their players better. It's official. Y'all saw it. Oh, he's so good. 81 overall. You know what? Let's shoot for the stars. Shoot for the skies. Aim for the stars. At least you'll grab a star. I don't know. Something like that. No deal breakers. Cali only. Oh, yeah. And no athletes. Okay. Wide receiver we could really use. A, proximity home. B, conference prestige. There we go. Let's try him. Nope. See, if D minus first, we're skipping that one. We're not crazy. A, B. A lot of these guys have the same thing. Proximity home and conference prestige. Which we obviously don't have the same conference prestige as USC or UCLA. So if they actually do go after him, we will not be able to get the guy's guy. But there we go. We'll at least try. A, B, nope. Athlete. B plus. Playing time. We'd have that advantage over the other, those big California schools. Only 71 overall? Why am I going down to all positions? I never do it this way. I guess I'm just trying to see what four star. Okay. Quarterbacks. He does not want to come to me. Nope, it's a deal breaker. Wait, why do I even have deal breakers on here? No deal breaker. Playing style deal. Oh, is it deal breaker? But I pass it. I don't know. C plus is still not great. Ugh. I think I should go for somebody lower. Playing time. Really, you want to play like immediately? Immediately? Like, I think your playing time. Besides that one starter, I think he'd be the next guy. Okay, this guy already has interest in me, but he's only 64? Alright, I don't want these. Oh my god, it's got me so bad. I just want to cry. I guess I'll. I don't know what I'm gonna do. You know what? Just remember, you're only on Californian right now. You don't have to go after the California guys. Let's take them off. You only have 30 more players to go after anyway. You don't have to go after the California guys. Only if they're actually good and actually have you right there. A plus, boom. A, B, yeah. Wide receiver, we've already got the top two. A, B, A plus. B, A, D. Because there are two schools of thought if you're at a small school. Is one, go after like the mid players and go after them early and hard. And then you can have like gigantic leads on them by the time all the other schools come around to them. So if you're going after like a 70 overall and you're putting full points into them every week, by the time San Diego State gives up on the 79 wide receiver and finds this guy and scouts him and starts putting points into him, boom, you're already like 50% of the way there, and you can get him, you can finish off the commitment before they can even catch up. That's one school of thought. The other school of thought is go after the big players, but do it smartly, like the ones that are pipeline guys or that just have big bonuses with you. And like, if you're going up against a Texas or something, immediately drop them and go after the next guy. And do that for like 2 or 3 weeks. And you're going to fail on most of them. But say if you try it for like 35 guys, but say it works on five of them. And then like on two out of those five, people come in late, use lock picks or things like that. You end up getting three of those guys. Well, if they were like 78, 79, 80 overall, boom, you just nailed three, like four star or both guys that could immediately be starters for you, boom, you just got that. And then you can fill in the rest of it later. And like every year, try to like that strategy, get 3 to 5 star players, like stars and scrubs kind of strategy. So I don't, having explainable strategies, I don't know which one I'm going to do. Maybe I should have figured that out ahead of time. 71, I think I know which one I'm actually doing. You can, because that's what I'm literally putting on the board right here. 64, no thank you. 69, no thank you. I mean, IRL, yes, but not here. Probably not getting that guy. A D minus, yeah, no. Let's not waste our time there. B plus. Why don't any of the offensive linemen want to come here? Come on. Do not like this guy's squat numbers are so low. A plus. Juco Junior. So if I sort by squat, that Juco Junior pops up, but this dude also pops up. D minus. 620 is really not that great. I'm probably not gonna get this guy, am I? No. Don't do him. Yeah, he's not worth it either. Let's go to guard. He's not a Juco. 655? Let's hit him. This dude's already interested in me. Good, good. Now we're down into 605s. Yeah, probably not. I just have to figure out which guys that, which guys the big schools are going to go after, the big Cali schools are going to go after. 69, 68. See, I think I'm filling up my board a little too much here. Ooh, that was a good one. That was a good one. No, because I don't need center super bad. All right, D end. BB plus? No, I'm going to skip that one. Because I'm already going after this dude. Ooh, 77. 66, 65 squat. Potential deal breaker? Okay, no. Eh. Outside linebacker. These guys can squat like mofos. Damn. Why do you guys care about program tradition that much? Why don't you start your own tradition? You wanna be at a school that's good? How about you make the school good? Then you'll be a hero for the rest of your life. C plus B A. Guess right, I need a lot of linebackers too. Dude wants to go to Wisconsin. All right, well, go to Wisconsin then. I can't get him. Okay, not a lot of good outside linebackers in Cali. How about middle linebackers? 555 squad is all? Oh, of course, you got great bonus numbers. Television exposure. I ain't getting you television exposure. 75, 74. Now you guys are down to the 70s. I think on previous editions of this where I like try to explain recruiting strategy, I'm like, don't focus so much on the pipeline schools. You can go to the general thing and find guys that like match their top three much better, and you're gonna get a better bonus from matching those categories than you would from the pipeline. Like literally the pipeline doesn't matter that much. I think in previous versions of NCAA football, like previous years, it did matter, but for whatever reason in 14 they really nuked it, they really nerfed it. How many? I need two to three corners. Because that guy had really good bonuses. BD, no. So this is B, A plus A. AB plus D plus. All right, let's put both those guys on. I don't like them. I'm getting close to 20 already, and I didn't need a safety that badly. Why do I have this guy on my list if I don't need a safety that badly? Every morning. All right, so that was the Cali Kids. Now let's see if I can fill in. Didn't have any quarterbacks. Look at all those four stars. That's crazy. I gotta find somebody with a good pitch info. Can I? Yes, I can. Use the right stick. Okay, so no. Why is it not working now? It worked a second ago. Yeah, okay, so start here, and then boom, down. Boom, down. A plus? No. I wish they would be faster to go down. Okay, potential deal breaker. Wow, that guy does not want to come to my school. Come on, why are these quarterbacks so picky? This is faster just to go like this. Wow. I thought California was supposed to have a bunch of... Ignore that. It's a lot of 70s. I think I'm gonna just ignore the rest of the quarterbacks there. All these five stars. Not going to get any of them. Playing time. Bam. So if it's playing time and proximity to home, yep, there's the schools that make sense. UCF, La Tech, FAU. So it's like they're where he's from, but they're the small schools, so they have playing time. Dang. Why couldn't I get a dude from California that cared about playing time that much? Jeez. Who wants to play for a great coach? There you go. Coach prestige is third skill. Oil City, Pennsylvania. That's an actual city. But yeah, the top two skills are not great there, and it's not a pipeline state. So I'm going to skip that one. Can I pair a guy who cares about playing time and coach skill? And then maybe conference prestige? That's what I need. Yeah, now I'm way down in these halfbacks, and these are the guys that are not that great already. Alright, maybe I will just wait on halfbacks then. I need receivers more than I need halfbacks. You really only need one halfback. The number one kid hates me. The number three kid. Oh, there we go. That's... not the best. No, skip them. You don't want to waste all your points. Like, you're shooting above your skis right here. Is that the phrase? Playing time. Really? Playing time and championship contender? How are those gonna match? I'll try. A plus with playing time. Coach prestige. Coach prestige, proximity to home. Was it this dude? It was this dude. Let's try. Forget about the list. Glendale, Wisconsin. Let's go Wisconsin. A lot of low 70s receivers here. A lot of not great receivers here is really what I'm seeing. Tight ends, 1 to 2, and I don't think I put any on the list yet. So I don't think I need, like, even if these guys were good, I don't think I would prioritize putting my, that might change my mind. Because, like, you can only, like, put your recruiting points into, like, 5-6 players, maybe. It's like, would I make one of those players a tight end? Probably not. But then it's like, well, if he's this good. Yeah, I don't think any of these. Right, oops, that's not what I meant to do. Tight ends. Who's got tight ends? Mr. Burns, Mark Burns. Jeez. That one guy wanted television exposure for his main thing. I was like, oh, I'll put you on streaming, put you on Peacock, Amazon Prime Video. How's that for exposure? It's everywhere. Right, I need some more offensive linemen. Not that one. I don't think I want to click through every single one of these guys. Proximity to home. I ignored him when he was in the California list the first time. Probably the right decision. 640? Television exposure? I mean, sure. He's got the 640 squad. For some reason, I could get the scout on him. It might be worth it. 665 squad? He doesn't want to come into my school, though. All these big squat guys right here. Dang. A? Oh, it's a Cali guy. I ignored him last time. Just gonna trust my judgment on some of them. Be like, you know what? I already decided previously that he wasn't gonna make my list. 640 squat? Nah. Gotta check a couple more of these guys right there, dang. I guess I don't cost a couple more 640s. BB D minus? Sure. Wait, why did that guy just disappear? 26 out of 35. Wow, 670 squad. Oh my gosh. A plus playing time. Dang. I don't want to waste points. I was going to say, I almost want to scout him just for the fun of it, but I cannot afford to do that when I'm in this rebuild. C plus playing time? Would that change if I didn't recruit this guy? Or is it just because this guy's a 76 or this one's a 78? That's not much of a skill difference. Or maybe the skill difference is that large. Wow, a lot of centers. No, stop it. Get that guy off your list. You don't need a center. Get these extra centers off your list. Okay, DNs. I said one D lineman overall. So I think I'm gonna just ignore that one. So I've already got one guy there. Probably not going to need any of these guys. All right, let's hit some linebackers. Dang. This guy's with the monster squad. Oh, you know, I think I already looked at both of them. They're both California guys. Probably the same exact reaction then. Dang, they're like such big squat, but they don't want to come to my school. I care about program tradition too much and television exposure too much. So this suit is from California. I didn't add the suit before. I kind of probably expected there'd be more linebackers overall. C plus, B minus, 655. Good squat numbers. Can I get any decent bonuses? No, I cannot. Ugh. Into the 72s and 71s already. Five star? No. C plus C B. It's better than what I've been getting. 695? I don't know how this is possibly gonna work for me. I'm gonna do it. That first bonus point is good enough. And I want to see the 695 squad, dude. Alright, I only got four spots left. It needs to be linebackers and corners. Let's check this. Okay. No. 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 Maybe? Two spots left? Corner. I just realized they don't give out F grades. Like, I'm seeing a lot of D minuses. It's because they just don't want to give an F. It's basically an F. E plus, A plus, C plus. Okay, sir. Come on to San Jose. Come to the Bay Area. Go to a 49ers game, man. Go to a GSW game. A plus, Cicero, Al Capone. B plus, jeez, 68 overall. Oh, my board's full. Good, because I was just about to be done anyway. All right, let's get some freaking good players here, please. Good players that nobody else tries to take. Wow, okay. Yes. That's good. Damn. Okay. All right. No. Bad. Hey. I guess we... I'd have to go look at his squat numbers, go back to the board, look at his squat numbers. I'm not going to go do that right now. Dang. Okay. Okay. Honestly, I like getting the boost to the stats, but a lot of these guys, I want to put them on my board if I wasn't okay recruiting them at their given number already. Dang. Yes, there we go. One of the corners went out. All right, so those are all the in-state guys. Now let's start recruiting the overall, scouting the overall 76. I'd still take him. It's pretty fast for a quarterback, too. 79, that's pretty good. All right, no points remaining. So let's go ahead and go to week one where we can continue our recruiting. Good. Oh, yeah, see. I feel like it's not totally random because I know which positions to look for, like, which positions need the big squat numbers. I was going to say something about the skill positions, but I can't think of any reason why I think I would be better at that. So let's just pretend like I know what I'm doing there. I mean, obviously these guys are all moving up. It's not just luck, especially at a tackle position. Okay. Yes. Damn. I think that last guy, wasn't it? Josh Gordon. He was the one where he had terrible squat numbers, but I was like, oh, the bonus is so good though. $68 bust. Oh no, it's a wide receiver. Why did I don't know. I think I just really liked his bonuses. A+. Alright, so our strategy here, we're gonna go to our list and we're gonna drop the people that were big busts. So we're gonna keep it in order of that we added them. So the in-state guys are first. So 67, we might actually keep him. 295, 260, 330, 300. This is really a debate whether to keep him on the list or go to add somebody else on the list just because he was such a big bust. You know what? One of those other schools is going to recruit him. They all have better bonuses than us. Let's remove. 68, same thing there. Someone's probably going to recruit him, and he was a bust. -2 isn't terrible. We can always add him back later on if we want to go after him. -66 was a bust. And I have the best bonus there. But again, we'll come back to him later if we need him. Really, that many in-state guys? Did my list get... Oh, I think my list got ruined. Valley, Indy... Oh, I thought I had him in the order. Well, I guess it doesn't matter, because it's baked into the bonus, isn't it? So 340, 330, 320, 350. Okay, I'm going to have to reorganize this then. I normally don't do this. Oh, I thought you could sort by position. Let's sort it by position ourselves. Give me all the wide receivers. You're the cutest thing that I ever did see. Because once you got them on the board and then you're just comparing bonuses and stuff anyway, then it doesn't matter if they were pipeline guys or not. Because that's already baked into the points. Jeez, I think 67, 68. I didn't bother moving these guys up. We can just cut them. Alright, 69, not great. So bonuses are pretty low compared to everybody else. So I'd be really lucky in order to get him. That one's even lower. So I'm going to drop him. That one's even lower. It's really George Perry is the one where you're the closest. This one, only Stanford is higher, so we'll keep these two guys on the board. Okay, so what's the next offensive position? Lineman, sure. Grab him. Why is there always a guy named Ryan Clark? Wasn't he a safety for the Denver Broncos? And then he became like a TV guy afterward? I haven't heard much about him lately. Must not have been very good. Either as a player or an announcer. Broadcaster, whatever. Wow, I have a lot of linemen here. almost like I need to rebuild the offensive line. Oh my god. I really want to rebuild this line, don't I? Jeez. All right, 78. Not likely. This guy definitely not. 115. /105. Jeez, why am I putting these guys on? 215, but I'm so far behind those other ones. And I'm behind, and he's not that good. 305, maybe, yeah, okay. Now the center, 75, what the heck am I doing? 245 is in the mix. 275? Maybe? Maybe? Maybe, maybe. And that's why you don't trust the bonus number it says on the left. Because on the left it says 140, but then you look at top schools, it says 245. So you go check their bonus points. It's plus 180 for playing time, 60 for proximity to home, and then 5 for playing stats. So that's 245. Which is what it says on the right. So trust the number on the right, not the number on the left. Okay, so decision time. Actually, no, not super decision time. I'm just cutting down my list still. So 280 is fine, 305 is good, 245 is fine, 275 maybe. All right, next offensive position, tight end. That's the only tight end. 80 bonus, what the hell? Okay, so note to self. If your first one's bad and your second one is only a B, don't add them. Quarterback. See the only one? Yep. Halfback, looks like he's the only one. On the Price is Right. Yep, he's in the mix. You're in the mix, you're good. Any other offensive players? Just a shit ton of linebackers, man. Alright, so everybody's organized now. Corner, 68 overall. That's not wonderful. 74, but I'm so much lower than everybody else. Why am I so much lower? Because I'm only B and C plus. Okay, so I think I'm learning a little lesson here about the bonus points. Don't settle for Bs. It's gotta be As. Even if you're desperate for that position. Gosh, I almost want to maybe keep him on the list. 265, I'm so far behind all these other schools. B plus, A plus. I mean, it's a good bonus. Just be realistic, you're not going to get him. Cut him. 200, that's not good. Dude from Cicero. Cut him. Be realistic, cut him. All right, D-tackle, 280. You're not too far behind. It depends on what USC and UCLA do. And they are in the better conference. They have the same proximity to home. And they probably have better pro potential. The linebackers, this dude, bad. 320. Wow. Okay. Legitimately right in the mix with everybody. 245, significantly below. 79 overall. Oh my god, that bonus is terrible. 245, significantly below all those former Pac-12 schools. Love you, Tommy Gaines. I'm not going to get you. Danny Robbins, 355. I legitimately have the bonus on the board. Let's go. A plus. Proximity home and coach prestige. Plus conference prestige. 150, that's not good. 235, eh. Alright, so we've got 12 guys. Who do we want to rock on with? So this one, I had the best bonus. Let's rock on with him. 320, I was right in the mix. 75 overall. Okay, so we're going to shoot our shot. We're going to shoot our shot with the 79 overall. How many guys can you actually shoot your shot with, though? If you just put it on the big guys, then you're not going to get any of these medium guys. Yeah. So let's see what that would look like first. Don't actually care about the quarterback that much. Just want to wait and see if anyone else is going after him. Same with the halfback. So we do have, what, six, 5.5 guys? More guys we could go after? So both the linebackers, the D-tackle. Corner. Not loving this quarterback or halfback. But then again, it's the thing. It's like, just go after them hard. And by the time, like, Wisconsin, you said, like, come around, like, oh, yeah, okay, we didn't get our first option. Maybe we'll have to this guy. Maybe we'll have a big enough lead. I don't know. We'll see. Two linebackers, you tackle corner. It really is. Linebacker and corner is what we need on defense. And then that's just a bonus. Offense is where we need. Okay, so we're gonna probably be behind, but we're not super far behind. Any of the 78 overall. Center, I don't love the center. Only a couple schools have a bigger bonus. Like, we have a better bonus than UCLA and Arkansas. So I'm definitely not gonna do that guy, but I might do that dude. Oh, 305, yeah, we're doing this dude. So two more. 330, yes. So one more guy, is it gonna be CJ Gant then, or maybe the quarterback? I do like that he's fast. Yeah, you know, maybe I could make him the 250 guy. Now let's not waste our points on our center since we already had kind of a decent center. Do 500 there, 250 there. But let's not forget to fill up our board again. So we're gonna go fill up our board full so that we can get on those players' top 10 lists. And then we'll advance next week and see how our recruiting went. So no deal breakers, obviously less than 20, everyone's less than 25 right now. So I have a lot of 23 I could add. B not good enough. Yeah. B not good enough. Yeah, keep that in mind now. C plus not good enough. Even though all the other numbers looked good. Hawaii. Okay, so that's why getting that quarterback might be a good idea, because I already looked at all these other guys and there's really not a lot of options there. God. Can people start recruiting these quarterbacks and like narrow down this list a little bit? Because this is sad. Sad, sad, sad. There's, oh God. This is getting ugly. JUCO sophomore? He might be the best guy. Because you're only missing 1 year and he's already 78. That's not a great bonus, but I'm just going to throw him on. Same for this guy. Okay, threw a couple quarterbacks on. How about running backs? Yeah, this ain't happening. A plus, sure. I didn't scout that guy? No, I didn't. That was the dude from Oil City, Pennsylvania. A? Oh yeah, I scouted this guy? Oh yeah, he's still on my board. I was like, what? Gotta find somebody good down here, don't we? Maybe him? Alright. WRs. Should I? Should I not? These are just going to be wastes of spots, but I'm kind of getting anxious. I want to move along here. Just want to move along. I'm getting pretty tired. Oh, God. It's 3:17 in the morning. Oh, God. Glendale, Wisconsin. I didn't have that guy on my list before, but now I do. All right. Oh my God. I'm tired. My eyes are starting to melt with all this bonus. Where's that dude from? Ootala, Tennessee. I almost didn't even catch that. I mean, that's not going to be a good bonus, but let's just go ahead and get 10 more guys on the friggin' list. Am I right? I feel like 99% of these guys I'm adding are just going to be gone in 1 minute after I sim ahead anyway. But like I always say, you got to put in the work if you're going to try to rebuild a program. I just didn't know I'd have to be working at 3:18 in the morning. Not a great bonus, but he's got a good squat. Okay, I'm still only in the tackles. Let's move to guard. Again, I have no chance at him, but sure. 665 squat. I already scouted this dude, and again, I said I don't have a chance at him. Let's cut him. Proximity to home. Four more guys. Guy really wants to go to Akron, huh? Never seen someone so in love with Akron. AKA LeBron James. B, C plus, D bind. Oh, I already scattered them. All right, two more. Skipping center. Maybe some of these guys? Playing time? Hours of day? Sure, good. Next. So like I said, I'm glad I'm doing this on a separate stream, so that way the next one we can start with the games right away, and I can take care of this hardcore recruiting stuff at a separate one. So those who aren't into the recruiting, one, shame on you. Two, okay, fine, you do you. But yeah, so y'all can find what you want. So Central Michigan's 1-0. All right, let's go ahead and see how recruiting for week one went. Why? What is the default order here? This really kind of pisses me off. Why is it doing this? Damn. You gotta be kidding me. But seriously, like, I did. Sort by rank, and I ranked them. Now I have to redo this. Alright, ooh, I lost 70. That's not great. Now, this is gonna be the hard part. Where I lose ground on every single one of these guys, and I'm gonna have to drop them all. Okay. Lost 150, I kinda figured that was coming. 500. Yeah, I might have to do the same thing there. I'm not quite ready to do that. I didn't lose any ground. Didn't gain any ground. I talked to her. I am somewhere near the top. Looks like I gained more than anybody else. I lost 75. Kentucky's going after him. Iowa's going after him. Dang. Quarterback's looking good. We'll see. Wisconsin had a little movement there. You know what? What happened? Because now it's kind of organized. No, actually, it's not totally. It's not totally organized. You know, I saw this part and I thought it was organized again. It's not. Plus 190? Who was in the lead? Nobody was in the lead. Interesting. Okay, so all those guys I put points in, I didn't put points in any of these guys. Let's maybe make some cuts before we waste any scouting points on them. Minus 5. No, okay, so that means I got on the board, but Penn State. Has them on the board, but didn't put points in. Okay, so I'm. Or maybe I was on his board already? I don't know. Because this one looks like I just got on his board. Yeah, this is the type of thing I'm looking to cut. It's before I waste any scouting points on him. Minus 40, that's not bad. 335, that is bad. Minus 150? That doesn't make a ton of sense, but I know it'd be too difficult to catch up. Quarterback? Oh, you know what? Do I still have recruiting assistants on? I want to say that they reorganized my list, because by the end of last season with Alabama, I was done recruiting and I just wanted them to like finish recruiting on their own. I forgot about that. You guys are not allowed to do anything. I'm doing it all on my own. Back the F off. Stop messing with my recruiting. Oh, that's kind of frustrating. Like, I saw this other quarterback. I'm like, I don't remember putting that many quarterbacks on the list. I'm like, oh, maybe the game put them on my list for me. Yeah. It's like a 70 overall where I had this shitty-ass bonus. I'm like, why would I put this guy on my board? I don't know how they would have done it. since I had my board full. So I probably actually did do it myself, but it was still like a warning sign that I was able to check. Okay, so back to this. Refreshing. Minus 5, 270, minus 40, minus 830, he gone. Minus 410, he gone. Minus 425, he gone. Minus 660, jeez. Come on, I wanted to like scout some of these big linemen. I'm not even in the top 10. Minus 560, jeez. I knew this was going to be tough to recruit for this school, but oh my gosh. Okay, minus... we'll leave him for now. Okay, I believe I'm... now getting into the territory where they're already on my board. So now my board's getting all rearranged on me and crap. At least I left these guys here. Okay, so minus 70. Do I want to go one more week? I don't think anything's going to change. I think I'm going to lose 70 again. Whereas this one, I do want to leave that one. Do I have any other linebackers? No, I do not. Oh my gosh. Oh, I was going to say one more week can't hurt, but I'm always telling people, no, one more week could hurt. Go and find somebody else. All right, corners, no change. Okay, really, the rest of the list is all offense. Oh, my gosh. Whereas those schools are gaining. Rough. I don't want to quit those guys. So I'm going to remember halfback, I'm bumping him up to full. So he wasn't full before. Do you have one more halfback there? Let's go ahead and scout. He's effing terrible. Quarterback, let's scout. He's not as good as he was told to be, but he's okay. All right, so we took care of. Yeah, we're not gonna go after him if we're going after the other guys. We're gonna leave him on board. We're gonna continue going after this guy. We're gonna continue going after this guy. We're gonna even add the other 250. We have no other halfbacks. Not deciding that yet. We're definitely continuing going after this guy. All these other wide receivers. We're gonna have to look. That one was fine. Minus 450. Minus 465. With scholarships. Keep in mind, with scholarships. See, minus 415. If I put 500, I could gain a little bit. But too far behind already. Okay, so that answers wide receivers. So, as in, we're going to start going after this dude. So I didn't decide linebackers or corners yet. Offensive lineman. Minus 40, minus 240. Minus 85, minus 85, minus 29. That's a lot of scholarships. Let's scout him. 79. Oh my god, how do you gotta do that to me? He's already scouted. 77. 66. Damn. So which two were already scouted? These two were already scouted? I might want to fight Utah State on that one. Let's do that. Okay, so let's start fighting Utah State for him. That means I don't want to do this dude. This dude's new, so if you're going to keep him on board, you have to go after him. And I think that's probably true here as well, right? Like, either go after him or cut him. Why are you so low? 115? It's the perfect time of year. Okay, so I only have 250 more. What do I want to do for these guys? Linebacker, linebacker, corner. Take the lazy way. Okay, this guy I definitely want to keep going after, but this one, take the lazy way out. No, I don't think it's lazy. Like, 75 is suddenly looking like one of the higher level talent guys you might get. So keep going after him. This one, because that one is just one school. This one looks like it's four schools. Like, you're really going to compete against four schools? I'm only 545 behind. I think I'm just going to cut my losses here. Underwear. Okay, it's not part of that. And run through with my gym shorts on. That song, that part of the song's not coming up for a little bit. Take a drink right from the hose. But it's coming. And change into some dry clothes. I don't think I have it in me to go run through and add guys to the list again. Okay, I'm gonna do that at the beginning of the next stream. But if you're watching the YouTube video, that part might get cut out of the YouTube video, so I can start the video with the game. But yeah, I think I'm just going to do that at the beginning of my next stream. So we are set with these points here. We're just going to fill the board back up to the full 35. And then be ready to play Central Michigan. I'm gonna guess this video was way longer than I thought it would be, but yeah, I'm trying to do my best to not cut any corners with the first couple weeks of recruiting here, because it might be the most important weeks of recruiting I'll ever do at San Jose State. So I wanted to make that its own video. Thank you all for watching, and we'll see you next time when we begin. I was gonna say week one, but when we begin game one with San Jose State. I might have to learn what their nickname is, but let's go. Horny helmet guys. All right. Peace out. See you next time.